You've got my two best pairs of matched pistols, Duncan, so handle them with care.
If I had eight, I'd treat each as my own son.
Pull off a few shots if you like. Get a feel for it.
I once fought beside a man who carried nine on his person. They were a boom in battle, but hindered his ability to swim, sadly.
Quite. Yes?
I long for the day where one firearm carries four bullets, and not the opposite.
I have a friend in England you may like to meet, Julian. James Puckle. He's working on something extraordinary.
Magnifique.
All right. Here's a simple challenge. Try to strike every target before the hourglass empties. Remember, hit every target within the allotted time. Bad luck. Try again.
Duncan, where are your wrist blades? I've never seen an assassin so ill-equipped.
Damaged, sadly, beyond all repair.
Have your choice.
Where did you find all these?
I did not find them. I took them. Is a souvenir. Two blades, as is the custom, eh?
Custom, aye.
Duncan, will you indulge us with a demonstration of your techniques?
Well,
We must. We put together a training course in anticipation of your arrival. It would be a shame to leave here without seeing you in action.
Yes, of course. Well, I mean, if there is time, I would gladly, show you what I know.
Here. You see? Situations well suited to your skills.
Have a go! A blade in a crowd is always the simplest. Nothing grandiose, just quick and clean.
Show us another technique.
Quite ingenious to use bales of hay for cover, don't you think?
the spirit? Secrecy. The advantage of surprise cannot be overstated, isn't that so? Especially around a blind corner. God blind me, that's a clever trick.
Your aerial kills have a poetic beauty, despite their conspicuous quality. Would you show us?
Magnifique.
Is it also possible to deliver a killing blow at high speed? Mon Dieu, such a powerful strike!
Fascinating!
The assassins have trained you well, Duncan. You chose a perfect time to leave them behind.
At great risk, I imagine. Betraying the assassins is never good for one's health.
Well, neither is drinking liquor, but I am drawn to its dangers all the same. And what is your business here, sir? Are you an associate of the governor's, or a pending acquaintance like myself?
Guns, blades, cannons, grenados. Anything that may kill a man, I am happy to provide.
A smuggler of sorts.
And how is your wife these days, Captain Rogers? Is she, here, in Havana?
I trust she's well, but I wouldn't know. I've been in Madagascar some 14 months hunting pirates. It took some work to dislodge the criminals there, but we managed it. In future, I hope to use these same tactics throughout the West Indies.
And how did you deal with that kind?
Very simply. Most pirates are as ignorant as apes. I merely offered them a choice. Take a pardon and return to England, penniless, but free men. Or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Oh. I imagine Nassau would be your next target.
Very astute, Duncan, indeed.
Best of luck with that.
Grandmaster Torres! Mr. Duncan Walpole has arrived.
See. You were expected 1 week ago.
Apologies, Governor. My ship was set upon by pirates. We were scuttled. I arrived only yesterday.
Unfortunate. Forgive my caution, but were you able to salvage from these pirates the items you promised me?
Yes, sir. I was.
Incredible. The assassins have more resources than I had imagined, but not nearly enough to deter us. It is a pleasure to meet you at last, Duncan. You are most welcome. Come, gentlemen. We have much to discuss. Convened at last, and in such continental company. England, France, Spain, citizens of sad and corrupted empires. But you are Templars now. The secret and true legislatures of the world. Please, hold out your hands. Mark and remember our purpose. To guide all wayward souls till they've reached a quiet road. To guide all wayward desire till impassioned hearts are cool. To guide all wayward minds to safe and sober thought. By the Father of Understanding's light, let our work now begin. Decades ago, the Council entrusted me with the task of locating in these West Indies a forgotten place our precursors once called the Observatory. See here. Look up on these images and commit them to memory. They tell a very old and important story. For 2 decades now, I have endeavored to locate this observatory, a place rumored to contain a tool of incredible utility and power. It houses a kind of armillary sphere, if you like. A device that would grant us the power to locate and monitor every man and woman on Earth, whatever their location. Only imagine what it would mean to have such a power. With this device, there would be no secrets among men. No lies, no trickery. Only justice, pure justice. This is the Observatory's promise, and we must take it for our own.
Do we know its whereabouts?
We will soon, for in our custody is the one man who does, a man named Roberts, once called a sage.
It has been 45 years since anyone has seen a true sage. Can you be sure this one is authentic?
We are confident he is.
The assassins will come for him.
Indeed they will, but thanks to Duncan and the information he has delivered, the assassins won't be a problem for much longer. All will be made clear tomorrow, gentlemen, when you meet the sage for yourselves. Until then, let us drink. Let us find the observatory together, for with its power, kings will fall. Clergy will cower, and the hearts and minds of the world will be ours. Rest well, Duncan. Tomorrow the treasure fleet arrives, and with it, your reward. After which we will discuss further schemes.
I look